وهاف فينيشت انتيرور ارتفيشال تيث سيت اب
اجين
ناو از يو كان سي وهاف فينيشت انتيرور ارتفيشال تيث سيت اب. You can see that we have a common central line between upper and lower artificial teeth. The incisal edges of upper anterior teeth are covering the incisal edges of lower anterior teeth. The amount of horizontal overjet is nearly equal to the amount of vertical overlap. The horizontal is slightly larger to maintain stability. The cusp tip of the canine is in line with the distal end of the lower canine, both on right and left sides. Okay. The cusp tip of upper canine is in line with the distal end of the lower canine, both on left and right sides. We can see now that the distal slope of maxillary canine is pointing towards the center of the crest of the ridge, both on left and right sides. This is necessary to create what we call lever balance. We will start now setting up posterior artificial teeth. We begin with upper first premolar, followed by second premolar, first molar, and second molar. As we did with the anterior teeth, we remove some of the wax block at the required area. We soften the wax thoroughly. Take your time for softening the wax in order to ensure proper seating of the artificial tooth and proper attachment to the wax. Use a cold instrument to move the tooth. As we said, the central fossa of our first molar should be on the crest of the ridge. The neck is perpendicular to the crest of the ridge with slight mesial inclination. The two cusp tips of the artificial tooth should contact the occlusal plane. Use your glass slab to make sure that they are contacting the occlusal plane. Use a hot wax knife to seal the artificial tooth properly. Put the occlusion clock in water. Return it to the cast. Make sure that your contacts are proper. You may find at this stage that some of the anterior teeth do not touch the occlusal plane properly. Try to correct them. It's not a big deal. Corrections should be made individually, one by one. Such alterations are probably due to dimension changes of wax during solidification. Make sure that here you can find that the central incisors are touching the occlusal plane with the canines, and the first premolar is also touching the occlusal plane. Okay. The anterior relationship is not changed dramatically, so I do not need to change anything from the lower setup. Soften an area for the second premolar. The second premolar is set up to conform with the first premolar. Only the palatal cusp will touch the occlusal plane. The neck is perpendicular in the vertical direction, with slight mesial inclination. It may be slightly depressed palatally. If you find any resistance, so remove the tooth, adjust its lower, its fitting surface. Needs a little more adjustment. If you have to adjust the neck of the tooth, adjust it in an anatomical way, give it the same inclination as originally to maintain aesthetics. Okay, we'll need to soften some wax. To help in retaining the tooth. Use a hot wax knife to attach the tooth properly to the wax. Put it in water, return it to cast, and make sure that only the palatal cusps touch the occlusal plane. Here.
Again, please.
Make sure that only the palatal cusps touch the occlusal plane. If you have both cusps are touching, remove the tooth again. And either you adjust the trial denture base here, to allow for proper room to the artificial tooth, or you remove from the tooth neck as we shown previously, but we already removed a lot from the tooth and we are not going to remove anything from it again. Okay. Make sure that only the radar cusps touch the occlusal plane. Okay. The buccal cusps should be only 0.5 millimeter away from the occlusal plane, nothing more. If you still have some resistance, you can see where is the area touching the tooth surface at the denture base. Remove it. And reattach the tooth once more to the softened wax. Attach the tooth properly to the wax, adjust it with cold instrument. Make sure that there is no wax on the occlusal surface or above the level of free gingival margins or interdental papilla. Okay. Put the occlusion clock again in water and soften the area for the first molar. If you examine the lens of the artificial molar, you will find it is much more higher than we need, so start by adjusting its length before setting it up. If you have to reduce the length, do not make it a flat neck. Produce always anatomical neck after reduction. The neck of the first molar should be inclined mesially, depressed palatally, in order to make the cusp touching the occlusal plane the mesiopalatal cusp. We adjust the occlusal gingival height of the second molar similar to what we did with the first molar in order to have a common occlusal plane. If this reduction is not sufficient, you will have to remove from the denture base itself in order to maintain an aesthetic and pleasing situation for the second molar. You are not allowed to reduce it and to leave only the occlusal surface, while this will be not aesthetic at all. Remove part of the wax, soften the remaining wax, you can see that it's already dropping towards the occlusal surface more than the first molar, which means it will interfere with the occlusal plane, and that's what happened. For the second molar, no cusp is touching the occlusal plane, only we have 0.5 millimeter away from the occlusal plane as a mesiobilateral cusp. One millimeter away from the occlusal plane as a mesiobuccal and distobilateral cusps, and 1.5 millimeter away from the occlusal plane at the distobuccal cusp. So you have to reduce from the denture base, from the trial denture base itself, to provide sufficient space for the artificial tooth. Put a piece of wax once more, soften it, and attach the artificial tooth to it, so that, as you said, the neck is directed mesially, the disto, the mesiobilateral cusp, is 0.5 millimeter above the occlusal plane. It still needs some more adjustment. Seal the artificial tooth to the wax. Put it in water, return it to the cast, and check for proper alignment. It's all right. As you can see, we have created now what we call a compensatory curve. You may find at this stage that the incisal bin is not touching the incisal table anymore, as the inclinations we created in the upper teeth preventing its complete seating. Remove a layer from the lower block opposite to these teeth to ensure that the incisal bin is touching properly. We can see now that we have an aesthetic pleasing setup anteriorly. Amount of horizontal overjet equals to the amount of vertical overlap or even more. The cusp tip of upper canine is ending with the distal end of lower canine. The central fossae of upper artificial teeth posteriorly is are in a line, these central fossae are in a line with the crest of the ridge, as shown here. Here is the crest of the ridge, the line with the crest of the ridge. Here is extension, and this is a common line here. As you can see, there is a common line. We don't have any parabolic curves. This is important for artificial teeth setup to produce a stable, complete denture. Okay? We set up the posterior teeth, the lower posterior teeth, accordingly to have maximum intercuspation. So, the teeth setup of our teeth, of posterior teeth, our determines the lower teeth. You may find it necessary to adjust the vertical lens, to adjust the lens of artificial teeth, of mandibular artificial teeth. Try to set it one by one. Examine it from the lingual direction to show that you have maximum intercuspation. In the area of first premolar, you may find it necessary to remove also from the tooth neck. Adjust it. Return it and check for proper intercuspation. Adjust the lens of second premolar. Soften the wax under it. Put it in place. The previous tooth. Close the articulator. Check for maximum intercuspation. You can use, as we said, called the instrument to attain maximum intercuspation from the lingual side. Okay. If the wax is slightly deficient, you can add little wax. Seal the artificial tooth in place with a hot knife. Put the trial denture base in water. Adjust the length. adjust the length of the first molar, soften the wax under it. Put it in place to have a common line with its previous teeth. Close the articulator. Okay. Check for maximum intercuspation. Soften the wax a little bit under it. Use a cold instrument to raise it a little bit to attain maximum intercuspation. Make sure that you have maximum intercuspation also from the lingual side. Okay. Seal it to the wax. Soften the wax distal to it a little bit. Adjust the length of the second molar. If you have the cast attached, return it to place. You can fix it with adhesive to the base. Check to find that the second molar bone is correctly in place and everything is okay. If you encountered some problems in the mesiodistal directions, it means your upper teeth setup is not correctly. You should return and check it again and not try to remove from the mesial or distal surfaces of first premolar from the mandible unless you check several times and you find that the teeth setup of the upper posterior teeth is correct and you need, for some reason, you need to remove from the proximal surface of first premolar lower. Otherwise, check once, twice, three times even to ensure that everything is okay and to correct the teeth setup without resorting to reduction from the proximal surfaces. As you can see, you have a common line here and the cusp tips of lower posterior teeth are in line with the central, with the crest of the ridge of the mandible. Such teeth arrangement also helps to provide stability of the complete denture. Okay. You can now try to clean your teeth setup gently. Do not soften all the wax under the teeth or they are going to be to move and the teeth position will be changed. Return the trial denture base into water. Remove the excess wax at the peripheries with cold instrument. And you can now complete the other side. We will complete the other side by ourselves and return you to you once more for occlusal adjustments. Occlusal adjustment is a very important topic at this stage to perform harmonious occlusal contacts of your artificial teeth setup. Also to ensure that you have a stable denture later on. See you in our next video. Thank you for listening. Hopefully you are doing fine. or any questions, please do not hesitate to contact me at any time. Thank you.